Let's return now to a legendary, a groundbreaking maestra of the 20th century, the Dutch-born American pianist and conductor Antonia Brico. While still a student at Cal Berkeley, she served as assistant to the director of San Francisco Opera, even as she harbored a very keen interest in conducting. Diane Worthy, a Pullman Moscow area violinist and teacher, has written a brand new children's book titled In One Ear and Out the Other, Antonia Brico and Her Amazingly Musical Life. In a recent conversation with us over Zoom, Diane Worthy explained how Antonia Brico traveled to Europe in 1927 to enroll at the Berlin State Academy, and how a lot of doors opened for her because she insisted on pushing them open.
What she did is she started approaching people and asking them to teach her how to conduct. She just went to Germany, and she showed up at Karl Mook's doorstep every day and knocked on his door and asked him if she could be his student. He said no for quite a while, and then I guess maybe he got tired of her or something, and he let her audition. And it turns out he was amazed at her talent, and he immediately admitted her to the school, and she became the first American to graduate from that school in 1930. And she did the same thing with John Sibelius. She showed up at his door because she wanted to learn how to conduct his works. She had a few letters of recommendation with her, but she didn't send them ahead of time. She just showed up. And anyway, he took her in. He loved her. Even when she was conducting in Denver, that's where she spent most of her career, he brought her back to Finland many times to conduct. So yes, she had a lot of tenacity and grit and perseverance. And these are the things that drew me in to her story as I was writing this book.
Nice references, to be sure. The German conductor Karl Mook and the Finnish composer-conductor Jean Sibelius. Diane Worthy there, speaking about Antonia Brico, who settled in Denver in 1942. Diane Worthy herself was a violinist and the youngest member in the Brico Symphony in Colorado, one of so many women musicians taught, encouraged, inspired by that legendary teacher and conductor. Now, recorded live in concert in New York in 1975, the Mostly Mozart Festival Orchestra, as led here by Antonia Brico, in the overture to the composer's opera, The Marriage of Figaro. Antonia Brico on the podium, leading the Mostly Mozart Festival Orchestra in that overture to Mozart's opera, The Magic Flute. That performance comes from a series of sold-out concerts in New York City, born of an Oscar-nominated documentary about that remarkable musician, Antonia, A Portrait of the Woman. Diane Worthy, the Pullman Moscow area violinist and teacher, has now written a new children's book about the conductor titled In One Ear and Out the Other, Antonia Brico and Her Amazingly Musical Life. It will be released this October. Our thanks to Diane Worthy for speaking with us. Antonia Brico, who had two orchestras named for her, and who was the first woman to conduct the New York and Berlin Philharmonics.